There's a huge misconception among homeowners and even among pest control professionals sometimes that spraying is always the best way to get rid of pests or prevent pests, and that is definitely not the case. Granted, I'm not going to stand up here and act like there aren't good sprays to get rid of ants or spiders or termites or wasps or whatever it may be. Sprays are great and they're a big part of my industry. But in today's video, I'm going to educate you as a homeowner or a pest control professional on some of the ways that I can prevent pests from infesting your home without using a single drop of spray or any chemical like that. We're going to be discussing three ways you can prevent pests from getting inside your home without using any sprays. The first is eliminating food and water sources. We're going to discuss that in just a second. The second is using a granular bait called Niban around the exterior perimeter of your home. I'm going to show you exactly how to use that and some benefits of using Niban. Third, we're going to talk about habitat modification, eliminating harborage areas around your home and making your home or structure less desirable for pests to infest. First, as I just mentioned, you want to remove food and water sources from inside your house and around the outside of your house. So let's start inside. The number one area to make sure that there are no excess food and water sources for pests to find include the kitchen. The kitchen has so much food in it. Obviously, that's where you prepare food. Make sure that there are no crumbs around your kitchen. Clean up those crumbs on the ground, pull out your refrigerator, stove and appliances, vacuum behind there. Make sure that there is no excess food in the house. Make sure that there is no excess moisture in the house. This may sound stupid, but some people have leaky toilets, leaky showers, leaky roofs, or they overwater a plant pot. That can lead to things like termites, can lead to things like gnats infesting your house, can lead to things like ants coming in and collecting that moisture. Every house is different. You're just going to have to check out your own house and figure out, you know, ways to handle those. Then secondly, on the outside of your house, same exact thing, just on the outside. Make sure that there is no food outside your house. For example, the number one thing I see is a trash can that just has food like falling out the sides, like, you know, chip bags or just random crap that falls out of the trash can. A lot of people just don't pick them up, and there's food all around the trash can. That's a big one that always leads to ant colonies infesting right around. A lot of times you'll have gnats and flies breeding and laying their eggs in there. So make sure that there is no excess food around your trash can. Another area, just like porches, you know, wherever you're eating, if you had a big barbecue over the weekend and dropped like 5 hot dogs on the ground because things got a little crazy, just pick up those hot dogs ASAP. Also eliminate excess moisture around the outside of your house. Make sure you don't have any leaky pipes under your house if you have a crawl space. Make sure all those spigots are turned tightly. Like, there's garden hoses right here behind me. See those garden hoses? Make sure those guys are not leaky. Make sure they're screwed on tight. If you have a leaky garden hose or a leaky spigot or roof gutters leaking or don't have proper drainage around your home, that's going to allow moisture to seep into your foundation, giving excellent habitat around your house for cockroaches, for ants, for termites, for earwigs, silverfish. Every single pest needs moisture to survive. So if you can prevent excess moisture, of course it's gonna rain, guys. Don't worry about the rain. Just make sure it's draining properly away from your home. If you can eliminate that moisture, then you're going to greatly reduce your chances of getting pests around your house. Next, we're going to talk about an amazing product called Niban Granular Bait. Niban is made by a company called Nisys. Nisys is sponsoring today's video and is sponsoring my channel, but that does not mean you need to skip forward past the part where I use Niban. I have used this product before Nisys was ever a sponsor for this channel. If that doesn't establish some credibility, I don't know what will, but now I'm going to tell you exactly how to use Niban. A bait formulation designed precisely for things like ants, roaches, silverfish, earwigs, crickets, even takes care of slugs and snails. I'm gonna show you how to use Niban granular bait. It's not a spray, actually formulated with corn, and the active ingredient is borate, which is a mineral salt, meaning it is extremely durable in the outside environment, so a light rain isn't going to affect the product's efficacy, or if you live in a dry area, extensive drought is not going to affect the product. Pop you on some gloves here, and you sprinkle the Niban granular bait around the exterior perimeter of your home. We're going to shoot for, this is a 4-pound container. On an average sized home, say maybe like a 2,000 to 3,000 square foot home, you're going to apply approximately 2 pounds of Niban around the exterior perimeter. All these pests listed on the label are going to pick up the Niban particles, feed on it, and that's going to eliminate the pest infestations around your house. So let's go ahead and continue sprinkling this guy around the house because I am here doing a service today. So I wanted to show you. I also wanted to mention, if you are watching this video in 2024, if you are a pest control professional watching this video in 2024, Nisus is having an amazing fun giveaway just for you. You see how this Niban container is green? Most Niban containers are actually a whitish color, which is part of the fun. They're having a green spring giveaway. Basically, you're going to order Niban as you would as a normal pest control professional. When you open it, if you get a green one, see that QR code? You're going to scan the QR code. Nisus is giving away a big green egg prize pack valued at $2,000. If you have any questions about this giveaway, go to nisuscorp.com/spring-contest. Of course, you're going to be using Niban the rest of the year. Just go ahead and buy a bunch of Niban. You're going to have many, many chances to enter. Let's go over to an ant colony I found nearby. All right, as you can see, if you have eyes, there are tons of ants on the ground right here. What you don't want to do is you don't want to sprinkle the Niban right over the ants. You want to sprinkle it around the colony, around their normal foraging area. If you pour the Niban like directly on the colony, they're going to be like, what the heck is all this stuff that just fell onto our colony? And they're not going to take it. But if you apply it like I did, you can sit here for just a couple seconds and watch the ants pick up the granular bait. Check this out. Three ants have already picked up a bait. That's four ants. And they're taking it straight down into the colony. So in just a few seconds after I applied the bait, they're already taking it down into the colony. If this is not proof of how extremely, extremely effective Niban granular bait is, then, well, frankly, I don't know what is. Let's just watch them for a second here, take these granulars down into the colony. Quite amazing how quickly they have picked up these baits. Finally, we're going to discuss the third way to eliminate pests, prevent pests around your house, and that is a big category I'm going to call habitat modification. Basically, in short, you want to make sure that there are no areas for pests to infest around your house. Things like ants, earwigs, centipedes, silverfish, roly-polies, millipedes, anything that nests in the soil or is a crawling insect, you're able to have a very, very big say whether they can establish a colony or a large population around your house. You need to make sure your mulch is a reasonable level of thickness. I guarantee your landscaper is probably going to want to layer on 4 to 6 inches of landscape mulching, whether that be rocks, whether that be mulch chips or like pine straw. So if you are stacking up layers and layers of mulch every single year, you're just increasing the habitat for all these pests. So keep that in mind. Also keep in mind things like leaf piles or junk piles, whether that be like a pile of firewood or sticks or leaves next to your house. I couldn't tell you how many times I go around a customer's house and they have not gotten rid of any of the leaves from last fall, and there are just piles of leaves next to their house, and they have an ant problem and they want me to come and treat for the ants. And that's going to be very difficult considering the ant colony is multiple layers down into the leaves around their house, and I'm not going to be the one out there raking the leaves away. I'm just going to treat the best I can. So please make sure that there are just no huge piles of harborage areas for these pests around your house. Make sure that there is no junk next to your house that's going to create extra habitats for these pests. For example, see that leaf touching the house? That is a big, big no-no. Now, obviously, okay, one leaf touching the house is not a big deal, but I see whole trees next to houses, huge plants just completely covering the house. This acts as a highway for all kinds of pests to grow straight from the ground onto your house. So that is my final recommendation on how to prevent pests from getting inside your house without spraying. Just to recap, eliminate food, eliminate water. Secondly, apply Niban granular bait to kill off any insect, crawling insect populations around the perimeter of your house. And thirdly, prevent pests from nesting next to your house by eliminating any potential harborage areas like mulch, excess leaf piles, stuff like that. All right, well, that's the end of today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you again very, very soon. Peace.